patienthelp.com. Can continue clapping. Welcome him on stage. Patienthelp.com. Judges, you can also give pointers, little tips if you think it can improve their business. Yes? Thank you so much.
Thank you for 6 minutes. Well, the world is aging, along with it the demand for healthcare. However, the supply of skilled healthcare professionals and the infrastructure has not happened. So there is a demand and supply gap leading to rise in cost. So the need of the hour is bring efficiency in healthcare. I am Dr. Adarsh. I am a surgeon. I am founder of patienthelp.com. I specialize in laparoscopic surgery, which means I do surgeries through 1 centimeter hole. And when I started my practice, it was very difficult for me to find patients who require laparoscopic surgery. And also for patients, it was very difficult to connect with a doctor who does laparoscopic surgery. The healthcare market as such is very fragmented. If you see, most of the secondary and tertiary hospitals are based in metros, whereas 80% of our population lives in non-metro areas. So how do we solve this problem, and how do we connect these two? So there is a change happening. There was a study done by Google which says 90% of the people go to internet even before they go to doctor. So in next 5 years, 50% of the world population is going to be connected to Google. So internet has done wonders to many of the industries. Let's take an example. I wanted to go to Pangong, a lake at 14,000 feet near China border. I searched in internet, and then I had to book a resort, nice one. So I went to Expedia, searched for a resort. Then I could instantly compare the cost, the location and availability of the resort, and I could book. So what it did was that it connected the right buyer, that me who wanted to go to Pangong, and the right seller, the resort which was in Pangong, who was looking for a buyer who wants to come to Pangong. So it made that complex process simplified. It simplified that complex process. So it's power of simplification. Imagine Expedia was not there. So I would have gone to 10 agents. They would have tried to find out if there is a resort at all in Pangong, and I would have been lost, confused, unclear. So this is the change that has happened, and we are trying to bring this similar changes in healthcare industry. There was a baby born with a congenital condition called craniosynostosis somewhere in the desert of UAE. And in this particular condition, the skull bones get fused prematurely, and the brain inside cannot grow, leading to a lifelong deformity for the kid. So it was patient for this particular condition. There's a very complex treatment required. So the skull bones have to be separated so that the brain can grow inside. And it's an artwork, not available everywhere. So it is distributed across the globe. In present scenario, the parents would have gone to 10 hospitals, 10 doctors, tried to find out if that particular treatment was available at all, what would be the cost, and what would be the outcome. So they would have got lost in this maze. Very few would have made out of this. So what happened was that these particular parents, they searched on internet for this particular condition. They landed on our website because we had posted for content relating to that particular medical condition. They posted a request for that particular treatment. They uploaded the CT scans and submitted. Doctors and hospitals who performed this particular treatment bought this particular patient lead and sent competitive treatment offers to the patient. Patient was immediately able to compare treatment, cost and location. Baby was flown in and the treatment was done. That's how the baby would look in a 5 years time. So we reduced 70 years of disease burden on this earth that the baby would have suffered. So that's the change we want to bring in healthcare. If you see today, 50% of the hotel bookings are done through internet. So internet has transformed this industry, and the power of simplifying a complex process, be it Facebook, it simplified socializing, or Apple simplified computing for common people. So our aim is to reduce significant disease burden on this earth, generate 1 million leads per day, sell at an average price of $2, and generate $1 billion revenue in next 5 years, be the first internet healthcare services company with $1 billion revenue. Differentiating factor is the business model of lead selling. it overcomes the legalities involved in healthcare. Secondly, it's a scalable business model and it's a very efficient business model. With a clear business model in mind, I searched for a technology, a lead selling technology. It was already available. I acquired it, modified, adopted. I asked Expedia does, I generated content. I did some PPC, I did some social media marketing. We have 3,000 visitors per month, 16,000 page views, and 10 leads per month, and 2 patients benefit every month out of this service. Well, want to jump, defy gravity. However, the challenges are that I come from a doctor's family. It was difficult to differentiate between an angel and a human because cost of real estate in Bangalore gives 10x return. I went to VCs, told them I had an exit plan. They said, what would a doctor know about exit? Now I have found a way to grow without the funding. Well, looking for superpowers, that would include recognition for what is being tried and mentoring and superpower of superpowers, funds. Thank you.
Right on time. Over to you, judges.
What is the, you charge from the from patient or from the service provider or both or not clear?
For patients, it's free. We charge doctors and hospitals. They buy leads.
And the way you get the leads is by what you said as putting content so that people come to you through SEO and all that.
Yeah, we put content also. Since we can do a PPC, we can target patients who are looking for a particular type of treatment and get them registered.
You don't get any percentage of the treatment?
No, we don't do that.
Okay, just an observation, it's great to see hardcore doctor coming into very highly technology-driven stuff.
Thank
well
you.
Done.
Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Tell me, I think you have taken the principles of travel, which is not a very critical service, and it's more price-driven, and assume that the same adoption will be there. How would you think that for a very critical thing, because if somebody has as complex a medical condition as what they are, invariably people will tend to talk to their friends, talk to people whom we know, and would go by that rather than coming to an internet site and then saying, oh, these are the competitive offers. I don't think this sort of service is likely to be price sensitive.
Yes, I would agree to you. One thing, there is a difference in Expedia and us is the business model. We are a lead selling business model, one. And secondly, if you see today, the patient comes to our OPD to find out if the doctor knows something because he has already gone through the internet and he knows what he wants. He comes in the OPD, tries to find out what this doctor, does he know everything or no. So what we do is we go to internet and find out what's written in the first entry and we try to give it back to them. So that's the kind of change that is happening. The earlier trend of going to a primary doctor then getting a referral is no more happening because they are moving out of their localities and the connect between their primary physician is lost. And so they are overtaking that channel and they're trying to directly interact with the doctors and hospitals.
Ladies and gentlemen, patienthelp.com, put your hands together for them. Thank you so much, sir.